There are a number of important take-homes that I see in the guidelines. We've grouped some of them into core communication skills that apply to almost any interview that we have. So the first of those is really to come in prepared. So sometimes we get really busy and we kind of go into the room and we don't know the whole story yet. We figure we'll figure it out when we're in the room. That doesn't tend to go over well with patients, because if it doesn't look like we know what is going on, it's hard for them to trust us, and we need them to trust us. So reviewing the chart, having the information we need, talking to the right people is really hugely important. So we can go in with confidence. Imagine yourself on a bus and the bus driver isn't quite sure where he's going. It would be very unnerving. The patient is looking to us to know what's going on. So coming in prepared is very important. It may seem obvious, but we don't always do it. Getting to know the person as a person. When you have a serious event like a cancer diagnosis, your world is turned upside down. And it's important for us to know who this person is, what their life was like before they were diagnosed, what's happened to them as a result of the diagnosis, how they're coping, what their family situation is, what hobbies they have, what do they do for work, so they can be seen as a person. And we can talk about their illness in the context of their life. It's much more meaningful to them, and it builds trust so we can work with them more effectively. Other issues can be simple things like nonverbal, sitting down, making eye contact. I think the single biggest change we can make is to listen more and to talk less. We have a huge amount of information that we could share with patients. There's a limit to how much they can take in. And we tend to focus on all the information we want to share. We often don't ask them what they really want to know or what's most important to them. So trying to shift the balance in the visit, not to make the visit longer, but to spend a bigger proportion of the visit listening and learning from the patient who they are, what they want, what they already know. So a very specific example, one of the most useful questions I find I can ask a patient is, what have your other doctors told you about what's going on? What have they told you about the plan? When the patient answers that question, I learn a lot about how sophisticated they are, what they need to know, what they want to know, what's important to them. And then when I speak, I can speak in an informed way, a way that's informed by knowing who they are and what they want. I can build a stronger relationship, and if I have a stronger relationship, everything else goes better. Goals of care is a big issue in oncology. We get very focused on what's the next treatment we're going to do, and we often forget to ask, or we feel uncomfortable asking, what's most important to the patient? Where are they at? So finding language to pause and in a sense say, we're in a different place now than we were 3 months ago. And can we talk about that? And can we talk about what's most important to you? What are your priorities? So that when we come up with a treatment plan, it reflects what's most important to the patient, not just some stagnant algorithm of what you do next in that situation. This particularly comes up when things aren't going well and the patient's getting closer to the end of their life. Giving them an opportunity to talk about what's most important to them and what they want to do with the time that they have allows us to do care that's tailored to them as an individual. Too often, we keep pushing aggressively with care up until the very last moment. If that's what the patient wants, that's one thing. But if it's not what they want, then we're potentially harming them and not providing the best care.